Hey, what's cracking, y'all? It's your boy, Mr. Loco, a.k.a. Loco the Smoke, representing the gay area. And you tuning in to the Good Conversation Show with Callie Pitts on Podbean. Come tap in, y'all. Know what it is.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Hey, Rue, what's good, bro? I want to let y'all know at 8 o'clock we're going to have a heavy discussion about closing California. There's a lot going on here, y'all. Let's go.
Fight the power. We got to fight the power. That's me. Algorithms designed to bounce with health and vessel. Lies designed to fill your mind. Now that you realize the prize arrives, we got to pump the stuff up.
Never got your photos, Nehru. I've been having you in rotation over here, bro.
Fight the power.
Part of this conversation, bro. They got a lot of this gentrification going down in your city, man. They tearing it up. Nightingale, how you doing this evening? Seen that. We're gonna discuss that, bro. Morningside and four other schools.
Go.
This is a journey into sound. This is a journey into sound. A journey which along the way will bring to you new color, new dimension, new value.
When all is ready, I throw this switch.
Pump up the volume, pump up the volume.
Pump that bass.
We interrupt this broadcast to bring you a special news bulletin from our on-the-spot passport.
Oh, my gosh. The music just turns me on.
Thinking of a master plan.
Death with the record. Death with the record.
Thinking of a master plan.
Death with the record. Death with the record.
Thinking of a master plan. This ain't nothing but sweat inside my hands. So I dig into my pocket, all my money spent. So I dig deep up, still coming up with lint. So I start my mission, leave my residence. Thinking how could I get some dead presidents? I need money. I used to be a stick up kid. So I think of all the devious things I did. I used to roll up, this is a hole up. Ain't nothing funny, stop smiling. You still don't nothing move but the money. But now I learn to earn cause I'm righteous. I feel great, so maybe I might just search for a 9 to 5. If I strive, then maybe I'll stay alive. So I walk up the street, whistling this. Feeling out of place, cause man do I miss. A pen and a paper, a stereo, a tape for me and Eric being a nice big plate of fish. Which is my favorite dish, but without no money it's still a wish. Cause I don't like to dream about getting paid. So I dig into the books of the rhymes that I made. So now to test to see if I got cool, hit the studio, cause I'm paid in full.
Pump up the volume, pump up the volume.
Wait a minute, you better talk to my mother.
Thank you for joining us in the show, Miss Lisa. Stick around for the 8 o'clock discussion.
Yo, what happened to Pete? Yo, what happened to Pete?
Death
with the record. Death with the record.
It's so fresh.
The night cats.
Makes me wonder how I keep from going under. It's like a jungle sometimes. It makes me wonder how I keep from going under.
Thank you for joining us, Sam and Calais Pitts. I appreciate you.
From
looking glass everywhere. People pissing on the stage, you know they just don't care. I can't take the smell, can't take the noise. Got no money to move out, I guess I got no choice. Rats in the front room, roaches in the back, junkies in the alley with the baseball bat. I tried to get away, but I couldn't get far, cause a man with a tow truck repossessed my car. Don't push me, cause I'm close to the edge. I'm trying not to lose my head. It's like a jungle sometimes. It makes me wonder how I keep from going under. Standing on the front stoop, hanging out the window, watching all the cars go by, roaring as the breezes blow. A crazy lady living in a bag, eating out of garbage pails, used to be a fag hag. Such a that's a tango, skipped the life and dango. A silk aunt princess seemed to lost her senses. Down at the peep show, watching all the creeps, so she could tell her stories to the girls back home. She went to the city and got so did it. She had to get a pimp, she couldn't make it on her own. Don't push me, cause I'm close to the edge. I'm trying not to lose my head. It's like a jungle sometimes, it makes me wonder how I keep from going under. It's like a jungle sometimes, it makes me wonder how I keep from going under. My brother's doing fast on my mother's TV. Says she watches too much, it's just not healthy. All my children in the daytime, Dallas at night, can't even see the game or the Sugar Ray fight. The bill collectors, they ring my phone and scare my wife when I'm not home. Got a bum education, double-digit inflation, can't take the train to the job, there's a strike at the station. Neon King Kong standing on my back, can't stop to turn around. Broke my sacroiliac, a mid-range migraine, cancer membrane. Sometimes I think I'm going insane, I swear I might hijack a plane. Don't push me, call, close to the edge. I'm trying not to lose my head. It's like a jungle sometimes, it makes me wonder how I keep from going under. It's like a jungle sometimes, it makes me wonder how I keep from going under.
Everybody share the show to your people. Let them know what we're doing tonight. Share the show to your best family member, the one you rock with. They're going to come join us.
My son said, Daddy, I don't want to go to school because the teacher's a jerk. He must think I'm a fool and all the kids go reaper. I think it'd be cheaper if I just got a job, learn to be a street sweeper.
Lisa, I would appreciate if you joined the chat tonight at 8 o'clock.
Because it's all about money, ain't a damn thing funny. You got to have a con in this land of milk and honey. They pushed that girl in front of the train, took her to the doctor, sewed her arm on the game. Stabbed that man right in his heart, gave him a transplant for a brand new start. I can't walk through the park cause it's crazy after dark. Keep my hand on my gun cause they got me on the run. I feel like an outlaw, broke my last glass jaw. Hear them say, you want some more? Living on a seesaw. Don't push me, cause I'm close to the edge. I'm trying not to lose my head. Say what? It's like a jungle sometimes, it makes me wonder how I keep from going under. It's like a jungle sometimes, it makes me wonder how I keep from going under. It's like a jungle sometimes, it makes me wonder how I keep from going under. It's like a jungle sometimes, it makes me wonder how I keep from going under.
A child is born with no state of mind, blind to the ways of mankind. God is smiling on you, but he's frowning too, because only God knows what you'll go through. You'll grow in the ghetto, living second rate, and your eyes will sing a song, cause deep hate, the places you play and where you stay, looks like one great big alleyway. You'll admire all the number book takers, thugs, pimps, and pushers, and the big money makers, driving big cars, spending 20s and 10s, and you wanna grow up to be just like them.
Oh, you're not in trouble. You're smart enough to be in a conversation. I would appreciate your knowledge.
I'm cool, I'm no fool, but then you wind up dropping out of high school. Now you're unemployed, all non-void, walking around like your pretty boy Floyd. Turned stick-up kid, but look what you done did. Got sent up for an 8-year bid. Now your manhood is took and you're a Maytag. Spend the next 2 years as an undercover fag, being used and abused to serve like hell, till one day you was found hung dead in a cell. It was plain to see, my man,
what? Yeah, man.
Freeze! Don't nobody move nothing. Y'all know what this is. Get him up! Get him up,
man. We down with Grand Master Flash and the Furious Five.
What is that, a gang?
No.
Shut up! I don't want to hear you now.
those joints in the chat. I'd like to thank y'all for hanging out with us on this Wednesday night. Y'all know y'all could be anywhere else, but I'm glad y'all chose to be here and see what we could create together, y'all. See what kind of energy we could create. We're going to have a discussion at the top of the hour at 8 o'clock. Got a couple of people tapping in with us to have this discussion. It's about politics and how they're treating California. I want to know if they're treating your state, your city in the same way. With that being said, I want y'all to have a ball at the same time. Enjoy your moment with me. So let's keep getting into this music until we get into that conversation. 5 days of fun. Shout out to all the new underground music we played this afternoon. Lady with the plan. Thank you, Miss Lisa.
And I probably won't leave until the thing ends. But in the meantime, the in-between time, if you work your thing, then I work mine. We came here together so we could have fun. Me and you, baby, going one-on-one. Now this is the last chance for us to get off. So either get loose or you ought to get lost. Cause I'm just about ready to do my thing. Cause I'm a stone cold New York rap machine. I'ma give you what I got, and baby, that's plenty. And never has one man rocked so many. I'ma make you wet and make you sweat. Just to see how funky you can get. Now when I'm on the mic, I do serve well. And I go by the name of the rapper Ja Lil. Now sit back, relax, put on your headgear. You're ready for a trip through the atmosphere. Gonna take you for a ride through the twilight zone. I don't need a spaceship, I use my microphone. So hold on tight with all your might, cause I'll be rocking like this for the rest of the night. It's Ja Lil, y'all, your master rapper. And when I'm on the mic, it's a sheer disaster. Of course, MCs crumble when we rumble. Some think I'm soft just because I'm humble. So all you MCs, I hope you're real good listeners. Cause in this battle, I'm taking no prisoners. I'm slaying MCs right on the spot. Cause I'm the master of the rap, the doctor of the rap, the jack of all trades, the master of one. And the thing I master is for having fun. We got 3 minutes left to rock this funk, to separate the good stuff from the junk. So get in the groove and feel the sound. And once you're inside, spread yourself around. From the bottom to the top, top to the bottom. Come on, man, we can get funky while we got it. Me and my partner from the start, we used to get together at the dark. Sometimes we rap, sometimes we sing. In the summer or the winter, cause it ain't no thing. And ever since I first came round, side by side with Bro Down, we came here to this here place to serve you all right to your face. Because this jam here is our showstopper. We did more than you, but I guess we got it. With the man of the hour, make the ladies scream and holler. Too hot, drop, too sweet, the beat is sour. I'm gonna set the record straight, and I hope that it is not too late. If you want the best, I won't settle for less. Put your money on me, I'm your best bet. Come on, one for the trouble, two for the bass, three for the ladies, four for the play, 5 minutes of funk, this ain't no jump. So pull your bottom off the tree stump. Ladies real pretty, city to city, but now we're getting down to the nitty-gritty. From the bottom to the top, top to the bottom, I'm gonna rock them while I still got them. I'll rap and shower, has style and power, and this is our disco hour. I don't know it, all of you have heard, so it's up to me to spread the word about the man that we feel. It's got to be real. I'm proud print on the wheels of steel. He goes by the name of Grandmaster D. So if it's all right with you, it's all right with me. We're gonna rock you people's minds with ease, with some help from the maestro, if you please.
For liking the show. Thanks to everybody who's sending us love. Let's keep it consistent. Let's turn it up tonight, y'all. It's on us.
Out the truth in a song. Now production made a little noise cause the crew is saying something. People have the nerve to take me for a gangster, an ignorant one, something closer to a prankster, doing petty crimes, going straight to penitentiary. But in the scale of crime, that's really elementary. This beat is now compelling me to explain in silence why my last gym was so violent. It's simple, BDP will teach reality. And I'm beating around a bush straight up, just like the P is free. So now you know, a poet's job is never done. But I'm never overworked, cause I'm still number one. One, 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 one. Kumo D, he's down with us. Eric B and Rakim, they're down with us. Stetsasonic, they're down with us. Dana Dane, he's down with us. Sleeping Bag Records, they're down with us. My lawyer Jay, he's down with us. Jive RPA is down with us. Naked Funky Music is a must. I'm number one, one.
Thank y'all for the love. I appreciate it. Y'all ready for this?
One, and in comes the two to the three and four. Then I drop the beat I have in store. Lay the lyrics on the top like a rug. Make it sound smoother, later make a dub.
Now, Latina sister in the building, Tick Radio. Y'all send some love to Baja, Mexico.
Nothing like an idiot. You want the record? Cool, I'm with it. Let the rhythm check you. Shake it cause it makes you. As I turn the knob to the door, you escape through. Going like a gnat, don't be a pup. And I let it play cause dress ain't funky enough. Rasta. Smooth lyrics that take place. If you want another reason why it must be funky, yo, I am not a jackass, meaning not a donkey. So I will play the game like it should be played. Drop the funk and do the mix so the bass will never fade. Ship it to the station in your jurisdiction. Brothers say I'm dope and the others think I'm bitching. No crowd can avoid the D-O to the C. When I'm P-E-O-R-4-I-M-I-N-G on the stage. See the simple fact is I am dope and known. I rock a funky beat without a chord. So you will enjoy the fusion, and I will ascend with.
Now, Mook, join us in the chat, y'all. Send some love.
I think I'll let it play, cause birds ain't fucking enough. Hip hop. Hip hop music, so check it. Listen to the kick, popping with a click, and with no rehearsals, I'm dropping funky verses. Stupid with the bitch, with the thing that you are relying on. You love it when it battles with the fact that I am buying on suckers. Never come close, cause of knowing. There's no stopping the dock when I am going, but in the event, someone would try to juice this, stop him in his tracks, show him that I am ruthless. I don't give a damn, don't think that I am joking, cause I don't think he is funny when you're messing with my money. And stick with tell me this. You gotta stop him, but with no frills. So I just drop him, continue with the rhyme, and make sure I get mine with no static, cause it's older than SMG to get my nine. But lessons I've endured, now I get it all, I'm fun and let it play. When the people say, Trey, yo, you're a fucking enough. To the sea. I need a break so I can check around. See who the hell that is sitting down. I want all chairs off the
Daddy Dr. Dre, kick it.
I'd like to welcome y'all to Wild and Wendy's. Wild and Wendy's. Y'all want a burger? Hey, but I'd like to welcome y'all to Wild and Wednesdays with my co-host Sam Pitts. We got some people sitting in with the chat with us today. We got Mick Moti in the building. We got my sister Bridget in the building. We definitely going to try to have Miss Lisa come in and tap into the chat. We're going to be discussing a lot of things going on in Inglewood, so we're going to try to have Nehru tap in with us, y'all. We got Prodigy, the legendary South Central Cartel, coming in and joining us on the chat, y'all. So we're going to try to talk about something that affects us in California. I want to know if it's going on in y'all city, y'all state, y'all country, so we can keep it connected, y'all. Make sure we know what each other going through. Let's keep the music moving, though.
Cadillac River dug a bone. Yo, don't give him nothing but a microphone. Don't stop, I'm not finished yet. You said I'm not the E. You wanna make a bet, remember this lounge. You in the danger zone. I figured you would, now leave me alone. You pick and you whisk on the four-leaf clover to be the E-double-E. Over and over, you intrigued by the way I do my thing.
Do what?
We got the mic.
No doubt, Smiley.
The capability to rap and chill, coax attacks MCs who tend to act ill. It's like a dig 'em smack. You smack me and I'll smack your back. I get goosebumps when the baseline thumps a sucker empty on ride. Now it's time for lunch. When I'm cooling on the scene, I notice one thing, I'm not bound. So sucker MCs clean. I consider myself better than average. Yo, I rock the mic like a wild beast savage.
I'm in the bottom of the state, I can't concentrate. I make a move like chess. I your checkmate. You know why I get Xania and Xania? Because of the DMD man. And when I walk through the crowd, I can see heads turning. I hear voices saying that's Eric Sermon. Not only from the women, but from the men. You know what? It feels good, my friend.
I'm the P-double-E, the thriller of Manila. Better known as the MC Cold Killer. DMP's goal is to keep the place jumping. And if not, we feel we owe you something. It's like Lotto, you have to be in it to win it. But if the beat is fresh, then Diamond J will Diamond spin J, it. J spinning, it has to be deaf to make you dance until there's no one left.
Cause you a customer. When the fox in action, I smell blood, no time for maxing. Camouflage in the green, my back is off. Plus you in trouble cause it's after dark. My eyes closed like Steve Austin. I got you in the square, I will let you run. Nah, that ain't fair. So I clear my visions so I can spot him, snatch him up by the neck. I said, I got him.
By now MCs, you're in over your head. My rhymes are hungry, but they haven't been fed. The process of elimination's quite simple. Let you grow like a blackhead and pop you like a pimple. Slice you like lettuce, toss you like a salad. Revoke your MC license if your rhymes invalid. As we go on, sucker MC sound whacker. Like a parrot and Polly wants a cracker.
There was a rap contest, nothing we can handle. At a house that had the mics on the mantle. Looked at the DJ and said, may I? Lit it up like the 4th of July. Because I float like a butterfly, sting like a bee. No, I'm the E of EPMD. I have a strong point of view on the way things run. Just shut up and listen and learn, my son.
Absorb that ass like bounty. The quicker picker up, I tell you up front. You're nothing but a sucker. The style we're using is no doubt copacetic. You try to bite and yet sound pathetic. Design my rhymes like a tailor. Floating like a sailor as the peak gets stronger. MCs get stellar. Not bragging, that's a fagging. Surely not fagging. MCs surrender. Raise the flags and give up the titles, but the signs are vital. I keep the voice tuned at a slow and swift idle.
Are you a customer? Get down, get down. I need a man-meal sandwich, yes, I need manwich. I feel good now, it's time to do damage. I feel like bowing, you know what I mean? Wanna rhyme one time to release the steam. When I got the mic, I get your mic like an actor. You know why I get over, I'm the master. I do a show pack, I then two is clamming up. Look for the microphone, then I jam it up.
He said you see me jamming at New York Tech. You got one right, fella, you deserve a check. How did you know? You must have been jogging. How would you know? The places I be rocking. Don't follow me, fella. Every move that I make,
I'm hostile now, so I give you a break. Research upon me, but don't go past the limit. Here's my card, and on the back is my fan club digits.
There's two things to check out, the words that I'm saying. Plus, listen to the good top playing. The boy is bad, the strings he's plucking. Fire rhyme after rhyme, watch MCs ducking.
MCs, it's the final countdown. You look tight, can you go the round? If you can, I'll slap your hand and give you credit. And if not, I turn around and say forget it. They say that I'm a party pooper. That's not true, I'm a born out pooper.
You a customer.
Smitty G,
you a customer.
Boy, Wayne. That's just you.
Yo, we out of here like that, yeah.
Talking Japanese. Choing, 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 choing,
rocking the house. Now as she walked out the door, there's one more thing. She looked me in my face and began to sing.
Rocking with your boy Callie Pitts on the Good Conversation Show, KGCN Radio, and this is Wildin' Wednesdays. I hope y'all having a blast so far. I'm taking y'all on this memorable ride. If you remember, you're old enough. I know my daughter Sydney not old enough, but she say she an old soul. My baby do be showing me she an old soul, knowing all the songs I know. We're going to keep getting into it. I know y'all used to like this one too. Sam, when the last time you heard this one?
Shut up!
Making music about the internet in 2024.
You talk too much.
You never shut up.
I said you talk too much.
Homeboy, you never shut up.
You're the instigator.
The orator of the town.
You're the worst when you converse. Just a big mouth clown. You talk when you're awake.
I heard you talk when you sleep.
Has anyone ever told you
that talk is cheap?
You talk too much.
Taking requests, what y'all waiting on?
The word,
like it is your job.
You should be a stool pigeon who works for the mob. You talk. You talk too much.
your nagging wife.
You talk too much,
then you never shut up.
He says you talk too much.
Homeboy, you never shut up.
What you want, sir? Hey, young world or teenage love?
Shut up! 25 hours, 8 days a week, 13 months out of year is when you speak. I'm tired of listening to the garbage you talk.
Why don't you find a short pier?
Then take a long walk.
You talk too much.
Percy to cut that iPhone on and log on the app. Tell bro to stop playing.
You talk too much.
8 days a week.
You talk too much.
Never shut up.
I said you.
Richard Rojo's joined us in the chat, y'all.
Never shut up.
You talk too much.
Brother-in-law Percy, to this request, got you, bro.
Hey, sport, here's a thought from the old school crew. A serious situation we all go through. It deals with your feelings, so hear what I say. It's like a day when nothing seems to go your way. Pass this, two people, they really like each other. He says there's no one else and she claims there is no other. The feeling's the same and you receive a notion to reveal your inner thoughts and deeply hid emotions. Times hoping they won't end. Tell your mother about your lover, also your best friend. You're mighty proud while you're holding their hands. Boys, yeah, that's my woman, and girls, yeah, that's my man. This person brings a summer warmth to your heart, and everything seems so great at the start. For she loves him, and he also loves her, and it's hard to turn back to who the person you were. But later on, problems start to occur, and the bond which combines y'all turn into...
Who still know the name of the person they was crushing on when this song came out?
And they don't love you anymore due to your attitude and other, or because you're not being true, or maybe they're just plain sick of seeing you. Word. Now it might seem strange, you better take hints quick and make the right change.
Don't a teenage love. Don't a teenage love.
When you swore the ball was rolling, they're gone, and part of your heart's been stolen. Get back on your...
My sister said, Timmy, where you at, Timmy?
With this dead relationship, hanging around and buying them stuff. You see them every darn day, yet don't see them enough. You follow them around and they claim
your... My wife said she know it was a boy, but she don't remember his name.
Attention, we all need a bit. Behind your back, they're saying, yeah, he's all on my... They're getting sick of you. Quite annoyed, and if you have passed for the picture, they're now destroyed. You saw what was happening, and you still let it. And if you ever let it make love to your girl, she can forget.
I remember her name was Tanisha. When I think about it, she had a mustache back then. Damn.
Time and you receive the words. Yo, this is from the heart, and I know that part hurts. Get over it from now on, don't take short slick. If it's not true love, you shouldn't deal with it. Just think of your future and what is to come, and pay attention to the words that's in this song. They go,
don't a teenage love.
Do you like the things that life is showing you? Where are you going?
See, I like hanging out with y'all. I get to thinking about stuff I ain't thought about in years. Y'all make me laugh. Johnny Gill videos laughing like that. Hey y'all, Sam says Slick Rick get back to backs, y'all. So here go that children's story. Let's go.
Uncle Ricky, would you read us a bedtime story, please, Mark, please?
All right, you kids get to bed. I get the story book. Y'all tucked in? Here we go. Once upon a time, not long ago, when people wore pajamas and lived life slow, where laws were stern and justice stood, and people were behaving like they ought to good, there lived a little boy who was misled by another little boy, and this is what he said. Me and you tonight, we're gonna make some cash, robbing old folks and making the dash. They did the job, money came with ease, but one couldn't stop, it's like he had a disease. He robbed another and another and a sister and a brother. Tried to rob a man who was a DT undercover. The cop grabbed his arm, he started acting erratic. He said,
keep still, boy, no need for static.
Punched him in his belly and he gave him a slap. But little did he know the little boy was strapped. The kid pulled out a gun, he said,
why'd you hit me?
The barrel was set straight for the cop's kidney. The cop got scared, the kid he starts to figure,
I'll do years if I pull this trigger.
So he cold dashed and ran around a block, cop radios into another lady cop. He ran by a tree, there he saw the sister. Shot for the head, he shot back, but he missed her. Looked around good and from expectations, he decided he'd hit for the subway stations. But she was coming and he made a left. He was running top speed till he was out of breath. Knocked an old man down and swore he killed
him. Sorry, got the legendary big prodigy of the SEC, y'all. Send him some love.
Open up a door there, guess who we saw?
Who?
Dave the dope fiend shooting dope, who don't know the meaning of water nor soap, he said.
I need bullets, hurry up, run.
The dope fiend brought back a spanking shotgun. He went outside, but there was cops all over. Then he dipped into a car, a stolen Nova. Raced up the block doing 83. Crashed into a tree near university. Escaped alive, though the car was battered. Rat-a-tat-tatted and all the cops scattered. Ran out of bullets and he still had static. Grabbed the pregnant lady and pulled out the order. Pointed at her head, he said the gun was full of lead. He told the cops, back off, for honey, here's dead. Deep in his heart, he knew he was wrong. So he let the lady go and he starts to run on. Sirens sounded, he seemed astounded. And before long, the little boy got surrounded. He dropped his gun, so went the glory. And this is the way I have to end this story. He was only
17
in a madman's dream. The cop shot the kid, I still hear him scream. This ain't funny, so don't you dare laugh. Just another case about the wrong path. Straight and narrow or your soldiers cast. Good night.
Knock 'em out the box, Rick. Knock 'em out, Rick.
Knock, 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 knock,
yes, y'all, we got one more song coming before we get into the top of the hour and have this chat with the beautiful people that's in the queue. If you want to be a part of the chat, just tap in with us, let us know. We will definitely bring you up. We appreciate everybody for hanging out with us, and y'all just strap in and hold tight. Your boy Cali Pitts got you, along with my co-host Sam Pitts. Let's go.
Right about now, you're about to be possessed by the sounds of MC Rawface and DJ Easy Rock.
Hit it!
Send him some love. I'd like to welcome y'all for hanging out with us on this Wednesday night. It's a beautiful Wednesday night. It's one we've never seen before. It's a blessing. It's a miracle. It was gifted to us this morning. I hope y'all enjoyed y'all morning. Did something productive with it. Touch somebody's life in your own family, outside your family, however it go. But at the top of the hour, y'all know we like to give y'all a temperature check of what's going on in California with the weather. And right now it's currently 8:04 p.m. your Pacific Standard Time, West Coastin. The temperature is currently 60 degrees. We had a high today of 73. We will have a low of 53. No clouds in the sky, just stars. It's pretty cold out there right now, y'all. So bring a jacket if you're getting out tonight, but make sure you're safe. And remember, we 420 friendly over here, but we suggest you don't smoke and drive. Protect yourself and others. Now, I like everybody that's in the queue. Y'all can unmute your mics and we can get into this discussion. I want to talk about things that's going on in California at the moment, and if it's going on in your state, your city, your country, your town, and you can relate, please jump in and conversate with us in this topic. Now, right now, this is some things that I currently seen on the news about an hour ago. So this discussion, I want to talk about what's going on in Inglewood, California. Currently, they're about to close 5 schools in Inglewood, California, just in the vicinity of Inglewood, California. Now, with me just telling you that, Big Pride, what you think about that?
Sound like the usual to me. I mean, they always, you know, closing schools or cutting off programs in the inner city, in the ghettos, etc.
But 5 at one time?
Man. I don't understand, you know, why they cut 5. Obviously, they having some budget shortcomings.
They're blaming the kids. I'm straight said
they're blaming the kids. What they said, the kids too bad. What?
It's to me, they're blaming the kids by this right now. They said a few years ago, before Corona or whatever, it had over 20,000 kids in Inglewood School District. They literally saying it's only 7,000 kids going to school now in Inglewood.
What grades is this?
This is from high school to elementary. They closing 5 schools from high school through elementary.
So they closing schools across the board? Like,
hey, the main high school is Morningside.
What? They closing Morningside?
Yeah.
What the
hell? What? Yeah, man.
I was finna say maybe if it was elementary, that a lot of parents now are homeschooling their children because of, you know, they just feeling like the system is just failing them.
But they saying so the kids is not even showing up in the school system.
I believe that. I have 2 teenagers here, and well, they go to school every day, but they late for every class. You know, I'm getting all of these parent porter alerts telling me what, you know, these kids, they just, well, what mines tell me is that the stuff that we learn in this school, why do we have to learn it? Because it's not going to be beneficial to our future. They're not teaching us how to cook. They're not teaching us how to write checks. You know, these kids is coming to me telling me that.
And I understand maybe the kids feel like that, but do the kids understand they can feel like that, but that has nothing to do with what they have to do in that schoolhouse to get that document?
And I tell them that all the time. But you know what? They always shooting back at me. Don't get me wrong. They be shooting back at me, telling me like stuff like, well, that was your era. This ours is different. But I try to tell them that's your first step. You gotta do that first in order. Cause you know, you can barely get any job with a high school diploma. You gotta have way more education.
One, I think a lot of these kids think they know, they think they know too damn much and they don't know enough. When they be shooting back, they think they shooting back with actual factual things, but you haven't even lived to understand the things you trying to use to back up your point. So I get it, and it's just crazy, you know what I'm saying? But before we jump out, Pete, and you made a good point, we gonna put a pin in that so we can come back to it, right? But okay, let's just stick with right now. 5 schools from high school all the way down to elementary is being shut down in Inglewood. Is there not a paper trail, but a connected dot? I see something going on, and I just want
to. I feel like you're wrong, though. They shouldn't be closing them schools down like that.
Because it seemed like to me, like, just think of the vicinity of the schools and look at what's going on, what they building, where they building it, in them same vicinities of these schools.
Right.
This is gentrification.
The build more stuff in the city of Cali, you know, that might be the reasons, but I mean, people, it's not cool.
Gentrification
has something to do with kids going to school, though.
Because they're taking the land. See, what they're turning Inglewood into is a place where they're going to need a high school or elementary school that can be private schools. It can be academic decathlon type of schools. Like they're going. I believe from what I see going on, they're putting so much expensive things in place. Inglewood would not be a place as we remember it. It will not belong to the people who was born and raised in it, who helped build it. It will not, because they're taking every in these vicinities of these stadiums and casinos. They just putting money in Inglewood, and it's all. And then if you look at it right, how could they say Inglewood went from over 20,000 kids going to school to 7,000 kids going to school? But all these people, a lot of these people still on AFDC receiving county. And we know you can't receive that if your kids ain't going to school. So how are y'all still funding them? Y'all not saying nothing about that. But yet y'all shutting down the school saying the kids ain't in school.
You got a point there.
That's a lot of kids not going to school, bro. Where they going?
Where they going? That's what I'm asking. Where they going?
That's a lot. That's a hell of a lot.
I saw it on the news. This is their numbers. I'm going off their numbers.
That many kids not going to school. I don't see that.
And how is we not hearing some type of pandemic about them cutting off people off AFDC for kids not going to school?
And that's
in regards to Inglewood. Inglewood been changing for hella years. It ain't nothing new about Inglewood. They've been building Inglewood up for like a long time.
But I remember the last time I went rolling through there, I couldn't even believe the changes that they made over there. I was like, damn, this is now, you know, what I remember growing up. But yeah, I think it is. It's all about the money. You know, this state is like that.
And maybe that's the thing, you know, because of all the gentrification and all of the building, a lot of people got to leave Inglewood because they can't afford it.
Oh, I got a friend over there that her house is right around the corner from the stadium, the new stadium, and she only have a 2-bedroom, and that house is over, it's over $1.2 million. She said they come to her every day asking her to sell that property, and she like, nah, I'm not getting up. This was my mother's house. I'm not doing
before
that.
Before I moved I'm off of Century, right, it was a thing going on. I used to talk to my neighbor every day. Older man, he used to work on his cars, low riders and stuff in the backyard, taking care of the people in the front house, right? Now, they didn't have a back house, just had a nice big backyard, and he was telling me how California was forcing them to sell the property of their backyard to build extra housing on it, and if they didn't sell it, it will be taken.
Well, I know I can see that too. I really can. But I know she been fighting for it, and she like, no. But she was like, I'll be, you know, she do her little jog and everything over there every morning, and she was like, somebody always coming up to her trying to, you know, buy a property, and she won't give it up.
Miss Lisa said, we see public schools changing every year in poor areas, and schools still segregated. It's targeted closing. And this is a right. And this is the thing I want to discuss about when I say I see dots connecting. See, I believe this started about what they was doing in Inglewood, because we know if we catching up on something, it's something they already had planned 10, 20 years ago and they've been in the moving. It's too late for us to even reroute it. Right. But when they start putting all them charter schools all over L.A., they was breaking up the school system as we knew it then. They turned Fremont into something different. They turned Locke into something different. They getting rid of Morningside. Washington ain't the same. all these schools that had staple legacy. A lot of urban kids coming through here, going to NFL teams, NBA teams, baseball. Like, these schools had legacy for black people to look up to. Hispanic people to look up to. And now they have start bringing in all these charter schools, breaking it up. Now the schools don't ever have enough attendance. Then see, they planned on these schools not having enough attendance at one point where they was going to shut them down anyway. That's where these charter schools come in at.
So let's hypothetically speaking say they shut down all of them schools you just named. Where the kids gonna go? They gonna start getting bussed out to the valley and stuff again?
Bro, what you mean? Let's say Fremont is non-active as a full high school. Locke, non-active as a full high school. We now see they finna shut down Morningside. Bro, if we go start checking at some of these other schools, they probably non-active as full high schools too. You know they have mechanic shops. They have filing businesses that function out of these high schools now. Kids ain't going to schools in most of these buildings. Most of these kids are going to charter schools that's built right next to gas stations. Buildings with no windows in them, bro.
Like jailhouses.
Bro, yeah. They exercise on the street, literally running in traffic on the sidewalk. There's no PE like we remember it. There's no basketball teams. There's no football teams. There's none of that. And then let me tell you, they provide all that kind of stuff. They moved it out to the outskirts. Now, if you want your kid to play football, you got to be in Riverside. You got to be out. You got to be away. You know what I'm saying? Where they put that shit, bro. This is a real thing. This is a real thing. And I've been seeing this happening way before COVID. This is not a COVID thing. And I know a lot of people think this COVID numbers. And I get it. Some of them are COVID numbers. But I've been seeing this happen way before COVID with these charter schools. With us losing all the programs going on in schools, and now when you see them having the balls to close five schools in an urban community in one urban, this bro, one urban community. This ain't all over LA. This ain't spread it out. This is in Inglewood itself. Inglewood ain't that big.
And for them to say that it's because nobody going to school. Gotta be something going on more than that. I can't believe that, bro.
Watch what come up on them properties. Watch what be built on them properties. That all you gotta wait is 5-10 years when we ain't talking about it and see what's now built on them properties. And that's what happened.
Yeah, what they gonna put in place of Morningside? That's a school that been there for hella years.
Nigga, they just built stadiums. We need parking lots.
I can see that.
We need parking lots straight up, bro.
I can see that.
That shit sound crazy as hell to me.
That's some true saying right there, though, because I can see that.
Where these people gonna park at, Pride? Do you be around? You see, that's the thing. Like, a lot of us, we ain't seeing Cali no more. You know what I'm saying? Where is these people gonna park at that they building these stadiums for? Them parking lots not big enough?
You know, I mean, I've been to Inglewood. I know, like Pee Wee, the last time I went, I didn't recognize it.
No, I'm saying go when a game on.
Yeah.
Where do you
go? I went one time with Percy to the football game, and when I tell you, it was crazy. It was hell trying to get out of that place. I'm telling you. It was overpacked. Nobody, it was crazy, Pat. I can see that.
This shit is real, man. It's going down right under our nose, and the people we love, it's like we seeing homeless right now as a problem of people without. We finna start seeing homeless as a problem of necessity. Like, I'm on these streets, and what's going on, and this homeless, it's gonna be out of necessity. People gonna be getting hurt, robbed, buildings gonna be getting evaded out of necessity, bro. Where these people gonna go? They moving them out of the projects and Watts. Where these people gonna go? They closing in on South Central LA, bro. From downtown LA, from Watts, from Inglewood. Where these people gonna go? From Carson. Look at it. It's stadiums in Carson. It's stadiums in downtown LA. It's stadiums in Inglewood. They gentrifying Watts. where are these people going to go?
That's why they making it cheap to live in Palmdale and Lancaster and Victorville and Adelanto and Moreno Valley and places like that. That's where they want people to go.
Where you get 2 weeks of rain and you get nobody got sustainable houses because it's flooded. When the fire season come, everybody ducking because the roof burning.
But that's true. They are all, everybody is migrating out there, you know, to all those cities head name. Even out here, they starting to come this way too.
Those are the problematic cities. So when it rains, when the fire season.
I'm on my walk today, and I'm coming back to the house, and the police car drive by me, and he look at me. So I'm like, well, this motherfucker looking there, right? It's my first time ever, like, you know, since I've been out here, that they just looking at me like that, right? So, I mean, I ain't tripping because I know I ain't do shit anyway. So I'm just mobbing on down the street. And he hit a corner right there on the block, you know, where you turn to go to my little street. I'm like, watch the mother. I say, watch, when I get to this corner and turn, that motherfucker finna be right there. You know what I mean? And when I hit that cone and turned, it was like four of the motherfuckers right there, not just one of them.
And I have been seeing them out here a lot lately too.
They jumped out on me. You know, they jumped out on me. Somebody had did something. I don't know who did what, but obviously it was a black person that did it. You know what I mean? And they got the bug. They got the, you know, asking me questions, but I ain't tripped because I was sweaty as hell because I had just worked out. So I'm like, yeah, they could see that I just worked out. You know what I'm saying? So I'm like, man, I don't know who you're looking for, but it ain't me. Shit.
That's crazy. I've been seeing them cops. A lot more lately too around here. Because you know,
the more
wasn't nobody out here.
The more people move out here, I'm gonna say that. I'm not gonna say the more black people. The more people, the more drama. You know, that's how it is.
That's why what's going to happen is as they get, again, people in South Central Los Angeles, be prepared. As they get L.A. ready, like Mick Mo said, they're trying to turn Los Angeles into a metropolitan like New York. They're trying to have it expensive like New York. So as they build
it expensive like New York.
I mean, nah, we kind of expensive like New York. We finna be.
Well, I mean, New York is just like LA. It got certain parts of New York that's expensive. Yeah,
see, then them other parts of LA we living in is gonna be them other parts that ain't expensive. See, the parts they force us out to is gonna be them parts that ain't expensive. LA finna be Manhattan, bro. LA finna be Manhattan, bro.
We want the closest parts to the airport. That's what they trying to build, and South Central happen to be one of them cities.
LA finna be Manhattan, P. It's like right now, bro, I'm telling you, for a 900 square foot apartment, bro, $1,765, bro. Right now, that's here. So
over there where you at?
So as they build it up, that's gonna double. That's gonna be 17. Some of these people pay $1,700 for singles, bro. Not one bedrooms, my guy. So as they build this stuff up, just like New York, it'd be $3,000-$4,000 for that.
But as you just said that, I'm not going to even lie because, you know, it's been hard for me normally to find a place for anybody. It's been real easy for me, but even lately, it's been hell me trying to find, because they built some new houses over here, and just for one bedroom, they want $2,700.
There you have it.
One bedroom, $2,700. Then they want you to make like freaking damn near five times the rent. Like, who the hell have money that?
And they want you with a 700 credit score.
Exactly. That's unreal.
Tell me, it's real. It's just not real to where we come from.
That shit is unreal. Like, I mean, yeah, people do have credits. I mean, a nice credit. Some do have nice credit scores, but I'm just saying, like, normally they asking for over $10,000 for you to move into a one bedroom or a two bedroom.
Because they trying to affect the people they want there got it. It's simple. The people they want there have it. You understand? And the people who they don't want there definitely don't got it. So it's easy to make that the rule and make people go on their own volition instead of forcing them out.
If there's no way in hell, I'm finna give somebody $10,000 for a two-bedroom to put down on a two-bedroom, and I can go and purchase a home. I'm not finna do that. I'm gonna figure out a way. I'm gonna find my way. I'm not gonna do no shit like that.
That's why I play. And like Lisa said, she said in my city, they made it illegal to be homeless in downtown and in the rich side of town. Like, simple as that. They made it illegal.
And they need to make it illegal all over the damn county, everywhere. I mean,
they forcing people. They force it in California. It's a force. They forcing people to be homeless. Forcing people.
I mean, it's a lot of people that literally have jobs that go to work every day, but they live in tent cities because they can't afford the rent.
Yeah, and now
they having people put like all these they calling them the tiny homes and the ADU homes in the back. You know, like if you have a piece of property in the back of your house and you own it, they want you to put something like that in the back of it so that you can rent it out because it is so many homeless people.
Look how they building those fucking apartment complexes and they making them out of bins and shit, those steel bins and shit.
Right. Oh, but
they weather resistant, hurricane proof. They actually built better than the houses most people living in the ghetto.
I'm just saying, but those is finna be like the new ghetto places, housing.
Yeah, because it's cheap. It's cheap to build. You buy a container for $5,000, you can renovate it for $10,000. You can renovate one trailer into a one bedroom house for $10,000, you buy it for $5,000. All you gotta do is find some land to put it on.
Hey, it's cause you said that, right? Because it's a place right here on Central and like 120th. They got containers that's converted into homes.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And I rode past, you know, doing the job in the community, in the area, and I seen them out there painting it. And I'm looking like, oh, so yesterday I'll go past there. That lot is almost empty.
Of course, it makes sense. I sent Pee-Wee. You see what I sent you for your backyard, right?
Yep.
It's nothing but a container converted into a nice lounging spot for your backyard. Looking great. Luxury.
It is. It's real nice.
And Smiley, I wanted to ask you a question. When you said Carson have three schools in it now, you literally mean they have three different schools running out of Carson High?
Yes.
See what I'm talking about? What is that?
I mean, shit, Carson's so small, just to hear that they got three high schools is crazy.
No, they got three schools running out of one school.
One high.
Wait a minute. You saying they got one? Well, is it the same name or three different names?
It's the same name. But
everything, you start in elementary or in kindergarten and you stay there until you graduate high school? No. How that work?
It's all high school. What they did was they put gate. I went to Carson High. Carson High is kind of big. They took a gate, section one side off, put another gate, and section the other side of the school off.
So and kids that's going to school in different sections of Carson High. That's what you're saying.
Yes.
Prison rule.
I had two nephews that went to Carson High, and they was like, when you went here, was it like, I said, we didn't have none of that.
It's prison rules. They teaching people how to be in prison, bro.
I mean, shit's different, bro. I mean, you know.
Fremont too. Fremont, like, not like that, but it's like a prison too. When I went to Fremont, it was nothing like that.
Prisons now, shit.
See, I'm looking at it like, all these schools that's closing down, they sending them to certain schools that's close to them. They send.
We lost Smiley, y'all. But I want to say we 30 minutes into this topic. I want to move it on to some other things I want to get in y'all brain about. Now, I was watching Pride. Did you watch Biden's State of the Union?
Nope.
Well, I did. I recorded it, whatever. I was going to play it, but I ain't even getting to that with y'all. But I watched it, and it was talking about, you know, I was listening. I was listening to his job numbers and what he did, and I was telling Chantel, like, man, you know, listening to Biden numbers, he been doing some things. These are the things that go unheard or whatever. You know what I'm saying? And we don't really know. We just be looking for the checks, or we be looking for big things to move, whatever. But his numbers was good. I was like, okay, his numbers is good. He's a cool president. He doing what he can, right? So, bam, I'm watching TV today, and they come out with California issues. And they like, oh, we $300 in debt. $300 million in debt, California. You know what I'm saying? So what they're going to do is all these jobs Biden's supposed to have created, I never understood how they could say they're getting rid of 2,000 unoccupied jobs. How did we have 2,000 jobs?
What is a damn unoccupied job? It ain't, I mean, if it ain't occupied, shit.
It's not a job, right? And Pete, and I'm sitting up here like, what, like the words they be saying to us just be killing me sometimes. They saying they're cutting 2,000 unoccupied jobs, but that's not saving us from the deficit. Not the total deficit, it's just California. And if they attempt to fix the streets, attempt to fix a lot of the crime issues or whatever going on, it will cost the tax people more money. It will cost the people more money in taxes. And I'm just trying to understand. How are y'all doing anything if y'all getting rid of unoccupied jobs that could have been provided to the American people? And that's not saving no money. And if y'all do something, it's going to cost the American people more money. Where did we win in this presidency with Biden if the jobs are unoccupied, but yet y'all counting them as jobs you created?
I don't even understand that shit, unoccupied. I mean, if it ain't unoccupied, you can't count it. What the fuck?
But they count them. That's what I'm saying. It's like they play with us with these numbers.
And I mean, it's that whole trickeration with Biden saying how good shit is and how the economy growing, but everybody is broker. Because even though the economy may be, quote unquote, getting better, the jobs don't pay enough, bruh. So even if you get a job, but the job ain't giving you a living wage to where you can survive, what's the fucking point? You still fucked up out here. Yeah, you got a job, but you can't afford to pay rent nowhere because in L.A. it costs too much. You know how a lot of the fucking people are moving to Texas, and the Texas people was like, don't come here. We don't want y'all over here. Take y'all ass back where y'all can.
But it seemed like the people are going to places with the thought pattern of the type of money they generate in California. When you go to them other places, the money you then make is not comparable to the money that's made in California.
And you just don't know how many people I have told that to. You know, Percy lived out there for like 2.5 years going while he was going to aviation school. And I tell everybody the same thing. It doesn't even make sense for you to leave California. Why would you leave when, unless you finna say for instance, let's say your job down here transferred you and you was making that kind of money out there wherever you go to move to, then you winning. But if you don't make that kind of money like you make it in Cali, you might as well stay here.
Yeah.
Because it balances itself out.
Sure do.
It straight balances itself out. So everybody wanna holler, Cali too high, Cali too high. I ain't leaving California because first of all, I ain't with all that country shit, but first of all, the thing is that it balances itself out because you got to go down there and work 3 jobs to even make ends meet. And then you down there crying because you wore the hell out when you should have just stayed your ass where you was, because it doesn't make a difference.
Agreed.
And it's hard to come back to Cali now. You leave here, it's hard to come back here.
Now, hey, Mick Mo, you want to jump in this conversation, Brody? Mick probably over there asleep, y'all. But, but no, though, man, I just find it crazy how they, you know, keep telling the American people, pride, like you said, it's getting worse, but they keep selling us this hope of
the pipe dream, this
democracy that democracy is gonna win out for us. We got, you know what I'm saying? But yet and still, it seems like the more we vote in a democratic way, the more we end up without. And we watch, and no disrespect to no one, I think everybody should have a right to live a life, but we watch people who are outside of America benefit more off American tax dollars than Americans.
True that. That's true.
And then we got to
vote this year for the president, but they not. I mean, I'm saying straight. I just believe Biden is gonna win. They gonna have him win again because of the simple fact they not gonna change no president in the middle of no war. They never have. So why are they trying
y'all
to
hear me?
Yeah, we hear you, P.
My bad, bro. My phone wrong.
Yeah, but they know they not finna they know that man is gonna win. They gonna make sure he win. Cause they're not finna change no president in the middle of a war. It never happened. Not to my knowledge. It never happened. I could be wrong, but I don't think so. Biden will win this term too.
Biden probably will win. I mean, because in the grand scheme of things, you know, it's more people that's leaning that way in the world, in the United States as a whole. I mean, you know, but anyway, I don't know, man. I'm not even really feeling none of these politics personally. So that's why I didn't watch the State of the Union, because I'm like, I'm not really feeling this shit.
And he kept saying that democracy is
on the ballot.
Yeah, democracy is on the ballot, and the future is watching. You know what I'm saying? And it's like a lot of fear mongering going on. You know what I'm saying? Because if people don't know that democracy is always on the ballot. You know what I'm saying? And if people don't know, the future is always watching, because ain't that's what this is supposed to be about?
Yeah, I ain't in all that fear mongering and shit. All I'm into is what the fuck I can see, because I'm tired of motherfuckers telling me, and that goes for all these politicians on both sides of the aisle. They tell you what they gonna do. They tell you everything you want to hear. You go and vote for them, and they be in that motherfucker for 8 years and don't none of that shit get done. None of it. So I ain't with none of that shit. It's all bullshit to me. You know what I mean? Like I said, yeah, you could say that shit's getting better, and it may be more jobs, like I said, but they not good paying jobs. You know how they be talking about, I brung these good paying jobs. I brung this many good paying jobs. Well, these motherfuckers can't be too good. If a motherfucker can't afford to pay his rent and buy food and still have a little money left, that's a fucked up job.
I mean, America seemed to tax you harder being a single person. If you don't have kids, they tax you harder. Like, it's way different of working, getting your check, and you got three kids as a dependent, than working, getting your check, and you have no kids as a dependent. The government is taking 35 to 40% of your check.
I mean, when you talk about the free world, and we call the United States the land of the free, and you know, young Cali, we done been to other countries, bro, so we done got a little taste of it in other countries, you know what I mean? But the United States tax the fuck out of their citizens, tax the fuck out of you. You got to pay federal taxes, you got to pay state taxes, everything you fucking buy get taxed. Everything, you can't breathe without getting your fucking breath, the air is taxed. Everything is taxed. Everything is taxed. So how is it the land of the motherfucking free? We pay for everything.
America sell us tap water.
Bro, they charge us for everything.
America everything. Is
I mean, it ain't nothing. It ain't nothing in the United States free, bro. Nothing. And then, unless you coming from Mexico, you can get some money. Oh, we gonna give y'all a whole lot of free shit. And I ain't even in that argument. I'm just saying. That's what they do.
Oh, man. I mean, it's just like, sure. When we think about it, like, we not getting no goddamn water from no mountain springs, bro. We're not sipping water that's dripping off of glaciers, bro. That's water through a filter. America sell us filtered tap water, and we buy it in cases faithfully. See, it's America not stupid. The people are. Excuse me, I love all y'all, but the people are stupid because instead of going to buy a Brita filter, we keep buying cases of water. See, we don't know how to fight back. We don't know how to fight back. You know what I'm saying with America? I'm just saying, we don't know how to fight back with America. We keep supplying America with the money, with the power, these corporations with the things they need. And that's our money.
But let's keep it a buck, though. Most Americans, well, I'm not going to say most, but a big majority, a big percentage of Americans is fucking sheep, bruh. They follow what they're told. They don't go research it. They don't go try to see what the fucking truth is. And then when somebody tell the truth, they looking at them crazy as a motherfucker. The motherfuckers that's telling them the truth, they look at them crazy as a motherfucker. But that motherfucker just told you the absolute truth. But you don't want to hear it, nigga, because you can't handle the truth. They can't handle the truth. The truth is the scary shit. The truth is the shit that you really don't want to digest, because that shit the scary shit. What the truth really is, motherfuckers don't want to accept that shit. And the truth is that it's fucked up out here.
It is, too.
You know, the truth is like being a vain person and getting old. It's the mirror. And you don't want to look in that mirror because it's like, I got to see me get old. Mm-hmm. And that's the truth. You got to accept it no matter what. And if you don't, you're going to deal with whatever you deal with. You're going to deal with not seeing the wrinkles. You won't look in the mirror. And that's just simple as that. You ain't going to know how to take care of yourself properly if you don't see what's going on. Even in this world, man. And I know it's the easiest thing is that most people just act like, man, look, I'm going to just go through it and I'm going to die. And that's my life. It's not an understanding or not true of a care, but it's just throwing your hands up. A lot of people throw their hands up and just accept what's going on. And I do understand, like I say, if we catching on to something, we probably 10, 15 years too late and the plan is already in motion. But it's also about, okay, jumping in front of the next plan. If we see what they doing, and like I said, like if I could have told people back in the days, like, look, man, these charter schools ain't cool. Stop sending your kids to these charter schools. But people like, no, they saying my kid's smart. That's why they taking them to this charter school. It turns out all these kids in them charter schools is just regular ass kids. They not even extra smart kids. They hustled us with that one. Oh, we're going to take your kid out. He's going to have a better chance. He's getting high scores. And man, y'all teaching them third grade. They was giving high school kids third grade tests, bro. And passing them off as numbers as highly educated.
You see, that's another thing, my nigga. When you pay attention to the world that you in, nigga, for a while there, and I don't know because I haven't checked it lately, but for a while there, nigga, we was lagging behind in education far as how smart our new generation was and shit.
The other countries was outdoing us and all of that shit, bruh.
Why you think they start giving their ass elementary school tests to catch up in the world? It's fake.
Well, I mean, but how are they really gonna catch up when they giving them elementary tests and these other motherfuckers is fucking mastering calculus and shit?
Because
so it ain't no catching up.
See, it's the catch up is perception, right? Ain't nothing in the world really what it is.
Because they graduating it make it seem like we doing better because these motherfuckers graduating with these ABC ass tests.
Hell no. Excuse me, brother. No, it's so when China throw out their numbers, we could throw out our numbers. That's all it is.
Yeah, just so you, what I'm saying is they throwing out their numbers, even though the difficulty rate of their test is 10 times what ours was.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Because America going to always find a smart people. They not worried about really if the American people is really smart enough to change the world. They just worried if the American people smart enough to go work in the mines, bro.
I mean, bro, it's a lot of shit going on right now in the world that make us look. And don't get me wrong, my nigga, from my understanding, still, by a large margin, the United States is the strongest nation on the planet. And it ain't even close.
Okay.
From my understanding.
Because United States.
But we let motherfuckers do certain things and get away with it and make us look weak as fuck.
Because the jocks will always run a school.
But you want to know something? I found out the school that my 10-year-old go to, they more advanced with math than my high schoolers. So they surpass the elementary kids, surpass the high schoolers.
See, we don't be fooled. It's because they changed the math and now it's being taught directly to them younger kids so they can understand it better. The math, the new math curriculum has been a process of change from what we learned math to what they now got it patented to. So these younger kids are getting the full spectrum of math like we thought we got it when we were in school. And the in-between kids always fall in the gap.
Yeah, because you know with these kids being in foster care, you know a lot of these kids are from place to place to place. So now they put in place, they call it a AB216 is what they give these high schoolers because they not, you know, they're not on that level of where they should be. So they give them a whole hundred, they lack a whole hundred, you know, credits to where they don't
they
have
giving
to
them
have.
A pass. They're giving they them a pass them so when they get into the real world, they're going to be handicapped. That's what you're saying.
Exactly. The asses is being hung out to dry. And I try to tell these kids all the damn time, but they, you know, these teenagers, they think they know more than you. And I tell them all the time, in this system, bro, you nothing but a number. You better be glad somebody like me is even here to care for you to make you try to make you understand because y'all going to slip through the cracks, babe, and y'all going to be right there at my door like the rest of them, knocking on my door, asking me for help. And I just be there for them. But the thing is that they think they know every damn thing, but they ain't nothing but a number. And they tell me that shit. Like they tell me that when we go to these places, these kids look dirty and nasty. We don't look like that. That's because you got lucky. You here.
But the government has transitioned the power of a parent. You understand? And the average parent is not a hero in his kids' eyes these days. It's like this. Like when you parents on TV now is T.I. You know, and this is no disrespect to them, Ray J, all these people we see on these reality TV shows, they parents. So your kids are watching successful parents raise kids, giving them all this stuff, and now your kid is looking at their household like, damn, a daddy ain't even here. Mama not a doctor, a dentist, a a motto or like, you know what I'm saying? It's like, and now, so when you got that, you have your structure in who you are is now being compromised because your kids are seeing a different structure of what they would now want their life to be. It's no difference than when we watch Different Strokes thinking, I wish a rich white man adopt me. I mean, I'm just saying, it's no different. But you know what I mean in that aspect that we had a mama loving us, but watching Different Strokes, want to live in a mansion. I want to ride in a limousine.
I want to get toys. That's an American. That's an American problem because that's the only thing that this country know is money. You know, the haves and the have nots is that shit is palpable as fuck in this country, bruh. You know, because if you ain't got nothing, you ain't shit. Of course, that's what they want you to believe, but you can go to a whole nother country part of the world and they be happy as hell when they ain't got nothing. Walk around here in dirty ass clothes, holy shoes, and happy as hell. Happier than the richest person.
You know, a singer.
They don't grow up based on materialistic shit.
Exactly. That's true. Because the singer K. Michelle, she said that. She was like, because you know, she went country. And she was saying, like, how out here in California or New York or whatever. For the red carpet, you walking around here, you trying to be in Versace or, you know, Donna Karen, having the best dress, you trying to be the best dress. But out there in Texas, they got some damn dirty ass cowboy boots, a t-shirt, a hat, and these people are so polite, the happiest they don't do all of that. And she said she loved that she moved out there because it gave her a whole, you know, different sense of, you know, of life, and she enjoy it.
And it's cheaper to live in Texas.
That's probably why Beyonce that trying to go there too.
Cheaper to live in Texas. Doing country
music. She ain't going to Texas to live. She just making country music because the shit that you know that she do for a living is kind of teetering off. You know, it's finally getting to a point where the hip hop and the R&B and shit like that is starting to not be as lucrative. And now it's different genres of music that's starting to make more money now. But you know, once again, if you start putting your heart and soul into your shit again and you stop following trends and following whatever the wave of the day is, people will still fuck with your music.
I honestly think when it comes to music, the judgment is very just stupid. Like, because, right, say I direct movies. My first movie was a drama. Do that mean I shouldn't do a horror?
No.
Do that mean I shouldn't do sci-fi? No, I should be able to go into whatever genre of art that my talent can handle.
I agree with you.
That's true, though. That is true.
I agree with you. But, you know, if you start off making movies and your movies are across the spectrum like that, you know what I'm saying? Then it's definitely going to be accepted. If you come in the game and your first three or four movies is gangster movies, then people going to expect you to make gangster movies. It's just they get stuck in the mud with you. You know, you got to be, if you come out and you across the board and you doing all kind of stuff, then you're going to be known as a versatile director, movie writer, etc. You feel me?
Yeah, but again, it's the judgment of what people expect of entertainment artists. It's like this. Even if I came out and I gave you three gangster movies, if I Martin Scorsese, your ass, Reservoir Dogs and shit like that, if I came with those movies, I still should be able to do Schindler's List.
You should be able to do whatever you want, and you know what? And the point is, you should do whatever you want. But see, that's what I'm saying, bro. When you doing it because you love the art of it, that's when you do the Tarantino shit. That's when you do the shit that's, you know, across the board. Because you ain't in it just because you trying to get the check. You in this shit for the art of it. And I mean, I know it's hard to say that about music, sometime, because a lot of the time niggas be so busy chasing that bag that they know that the music take a hit. Because now they listening to the radio, whatever the hottest shit on the radio is, they mimicking that shit. And then that's why the music thing got boring as hell. And that's not a knock on no artist, no particular artist. I just like when people go in the studio and just create, create, create. Not create what we done already heard. Give me some new shit. Go in there and make something dope. Just go in there to create. Don't go in there to recreate somebody else's stuff. If it's yours, like how we go and we'll remake our own song because they done took it off of a streaming site or something, that's different. But I mean, when you go in there, if we was to listen to Kendrick Lamar album and then we go in the studio and go and try to make what Kendrick Lamar got, then what are we doing? That ain't our shit. We stealing somebody else's vibe.
And what was done. I guess you will be being an American.
That's pretty much what we do out here, bro.
That's
you digging me? That's what we do out here. Whatever it is that's popping, that's what we want. If it's the car that's popping, the clothes that's popping, hey, what everybody else watching, whatever that is, man, you seen such and such? You need to go watch that. Now, everybody watching that, let me discover it on my own, nigga.
Right. No, that's true, though, because we do follow the leader.
We do.
We feel like doing watching what everybody else watching, you can be a part of the conversation. I think a lot
that's
of things
with
Americans, we afraid to not be a part of the know. If we out the know, it's a disaster.
I mean, we lost the trend. We, New York and L.A. was one of the meccas as far as setting trends in the music, and we lost that. Had it for most of the last 10 years or more.
I mean, I would say Miami and Atlanta is the meccas now.
You know, I mean, now who? I mean, I don't know. Honestly, I don't know who it is now, hey, bro. To be honest with you.
Hey, I follow the Atlanta music. Miami, Atlanta. Got it all, yeah, because even if you a big heavy wig from New York, you pretty much live in Miami. If you a big heavy wig from LA, you pretty much live in Miami or Atlanta. And Atlanta's just popping on its own. Like, where the rappers coming from besides Miami and Atlanta?
I don't know where they coming from, bro, because I think everything is starting to flatline across the board. I don't know where they coming from. Maybe Memphis? Memphis is hot right now.
Memphis is hot, but Memphis don't have the plethora. See, when you talking about taking over meccas and you think of New York or you think of L.A., that's a plethora of...
I'm not talking about a mecca. I'm talking about where the hot artists coming from.
I said the new meccas was Atlanta and Miami.
Because even when L.A. not... Even when L.A. not hot, this is still a mecca for the music
business. New York
business.
Is going to always be the mecca. LA is going to be the mecca. And I think, like if you think of the plethora of artists that Atlanta, who dropped more artists in Atlanta in the last 10 years?
Nobody.
Then look at Miami. Nobody. Half everybody else come from Miami. They doing their thing. They holding the crown. Like Chicago came in and did a wave.
Yeah, but I mean, right now Memphis got a lot, bro. You gotta pay attention.
I give Memphis is on a wave like Chicago. Now, if 10 more cats come out of there that be well known, like Atlanta delivered us or like Miami delivered us, But it's no knock to nobody because, like you said, the game is flatlining a little bit. It's hard to find the consistent flow.
Mm-hmm. And some of the people that deserve it, they don't get it. You know, some people that is putting that work in and being consistent, they popping, but they not popping how they should be. Unfortunately.
Since I got you up here, man, we lost the homegirl Boss not too long ago.
Yeah, rest in peace to Boss, man.
Right. Boss was, little, I would say, involved with us than she was a lot of other dudes or whatever. You produced and you know what I'm saying? She rapped on your beats and shit like that. When you lose somebody in the game, because like this music business is a fraternity in a way, you know what I'm saying? But when you lose somebody in the game who you, I would say, I'm going to put it in this way, that you went to school with, you know what I'm saying, you was in a fraternity with, how do you feel about it? Is it different?
It's like that old damn, man, another one, you know, it's like losing almost like a cousin, man, like a family member in a way, bruh, you know, especially if they was solid, you know what I mean? Because in the music business, it's a lot of wishy-washies, you know what I'm saying? But Boss was always solid, always. So, you know, it's sad to see that, man.
I heard she was down there making new music with Daz in Atlanta before all this.
Wow. Yeah, man, you know, I say it all the time, man. Love me while I'm still here. Don't wait until I die and all of a sudden I'm getting all this love and shit. You know what I mean? Like, you got to give these artists they flowers while they still on the planet. You know, because I guarantee you Boss didn't know she had that much love when she was still here. You feel me?
Hell no. Because don't nobody say your name. Nobody mention you. And again, we got another comrade going through it. I'm hearing Fote got stage 4 melanoma cancer. You know, that's bone cancer.
Damn. And that's another super solid individual. You know, that's another super solid individual, man. I remember Fote called me up like, "Prob, man, we need to do one. He was talking about doing a whole album together, but I just never got a chance to link up with him and do it, man. But he was always one of the most solid, bro. He never changed. You know what I'm saying? Like some of these rappers, when you see them, and you talk to them one-on-one, they the coolest. But when you see them in a public setting and it's a lot of other artists around, they act like they don't really know you. You feel me?
Yeah, I think it's that acting. It's the entertainment. It's the rapper's persona is I'm the guy. And one thing I notice about most rappers, they groupies. Because soon as the guy that's really the guy, or the guy that's bigger than the guy you think you are come around, I watch a lot of dudes start acting personas instead of being the dude who you was just probably talking to a minute ago.
They turn into dick riders. They jump on the nuts of the big guy. Straight up. It's a fact, brother. And I mean, I've seen this many, many times. I don't give a damn, but unfortunately, that's just how it is.
Because, again, I think it's the entertainment part. It's like, one thing I notice about artists, they don't like to admit a lot of the shit is entertainment for them as well. And I know artists know more than the fans. They know more than the fans. They know when they bullshitting the fans. They know when they faking the funk. They know when, you know who you are. You know what I'm saying? And that's what it be. It's like that fakeness. And that's what make it fake. Because you acting, bro. You being something that like you say, if I catch you just out, I run into you at Universal City Walk, nigga, we gonna chop it up like we knew each other. We know everything, you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. But then once you get on TV, you gonna mention every nigga who you told me don't be showing you love. And you ain't gonna say nothing about me.
You know, and yeah. The niggas who are like that, the niggas who are really like that, who act normal, shall I say, it's the niggas that I cater to that I fuck with, bruh. You know what I mean? Like, if I talk to you today and I talk to you a year from now and it's like we've been talking that whole year. You know what I mean? Like, even with any time I saw Tupac, he was the same, bruh. And he didn't give a damn who he was with. He didn't give a damn who was in the room. That nigga came up to me and shook my hand like, "What up, Pride?" Every time. And he didn't have to do that because you know me, I'm not the type of nigga that's gonna demand no attention nowhere because I don't give a fuck. But he just one of those real niggas that didn't change up on you just because somebody else might have been there. You know what I'm saying? Niggas who do that is fake.
Like, and it's one thing, like, we be out, my wife be with me and shit, and she be like, take a picture with that person, take a picture with that person. And over the 20 years we've been together, she know I've only took a picture with several dudes. Because I don't do the photo op thing because dudes are weird. And over the years, the picture ops I done took, Eazy-E, a real dude who always acted the same with me whenever he seen me, acknowledged me for being me, not for being a rap nigga, not for being Cartel, just know me as who he know me as, young nigga, I'm that young nigga, you know what I'm saying, I'm at the record store in Compton, it's the same shit. And it's not MC8, always treated me the same when I seen him. I don't know how niggas treat me behind my back, but I know when I see a nigga, it's the same. I feel comfortable with that nigga. A nigga like Spice, it's like, it's just going to be certain people, and it's just ironically, it's people who've been involved with us over the years. Chill. You know what I'm saying? Corrupt. It's just not everybody, bro. It's the last nigga I think I took a picture with, shout out to my nigga Badass, rest in peace, because that nigga know me as me, as my, you know, my government type shit. But the last dude I took a photo with out of respect because I liked the way he moved, he was just a cool-ass nigga, was Compton A.V., and that was at that show we had did out there. I think it was in San Bernardino or somewhere, one of them car shows we had did. But, yeah, these rappers aren't. I take that back. DJ Quick was the last dude. And, again, finally having a conversation with him after 20 years. And he's one of the coolest dudes I ever met in this game.
Yeah, some of the ones who you think might be Hollywood, they're not.
No.
They're not.
One
so
that you
anyway,
think that's
man,
not
you know,
is.
And some of the, yeah, exactly.
You'd be like, this nigga should have no reason to be Hollywood, but yet he is. So that's fine. But, hey, I'm going to get back into this mix, man. I like to thank everybody for hanging out with us with this chat. Sir, thank you for coming in with your advice. Big Bro, thank you for tapping in. Mick Mode, I know you tried to tap in. HG Smiley, thank you for tapping in with your information, man. Again, y'all, I just try to see if we connecting around the world as we dealing with the same things with our communities, with our politicians, with just how we feel about how the world is turning out, the people, the kids, the love that's not being apparent nowadays. But, hey, it was a good conversation, man. It's always good to see my brother's thoughts because he's a very intelligent dude. And, like, y'all heard him when he rapping. I told y'all, I get it from him, man. No doubt, I let him hear yo that crazy joint. They went crazy over that joint this afternoon, P. But yeah, man. Again, thank everybody for joining us in the queue. We appreciate y'all. If y'all hang around, request some music. If something y'all want to hear, let me know. Let's get into this mix.
Yes, sir.
Bust it.
Here's a jam for all the fellas. Try to do what those ladies tell us. Get shot down cause you're overzealous. Play hard to get females get jealous. Okay, smarty, go to a party. Girls are scantily clad and showing body. A chick walks by, you wish you could sex her, but you're standing on the wall like you was Poindexter. Next day's function, high class luncheon. Food is served and you're stone cold munching. Music comes on, people start to dance, but then you ate so much you nearly split your pants. A girl starts walking, guys start gawking. Sits down next to you and starts talking. Says she wanna dance cause she likes the groove. So come on, fatso, and just bust the move. Bust the move. And you're wishing someone could cure your lonely condition. Looking for love in all the wrong places. No fine girls, just ugly faces. From frustration, first inclination is to become a monk and leave the situation. But every dark tunnel has a light of hope. So don't hang yourself with a celibate rope. New movie showing, so you're going. Could care less about the five you're blowing. Theater gets dark just to start the show. Then you spot a fine woman sitting in your row. She's dressed in the yellow. She says, hello, come sit next to me, you fine fellow. You run over there without a second to lose. And what comes next? Hey, bust the move. Just bust the move.
seem witty. Tell a funny joke just to get some play. Then you try to make a move and she says no way. Girls are faking, goodness saking. They want a man who brings home the bacon. Got no money and you got no car, then you got no woman. And there you are. Some girls are sadistic, materialistic. Looking for a man makes them opportunistic. They're lying on the beach perpetrating a tan so that a brother with money can be their man. So on the beach you're strolling, real high rolling. Everything you have is yours and not stolen. A girl runs up with something to prove, so don't just stand there and bust the move. Break it down for me, fellas. Has a brother Larry. In 5 days from now he's gonna marry. He's hoping you can make it there if you can, cause in the ceremony you'll be the best man. You say neato, check your libido, and roll to the church in your new tuxedo. The bride walks down just to start the wedding, and there's one more girl you won't be getting. So you start thinking, then you start blinking. A bridemaid looks and thinks that you're winking. She thinks you're kinda cute, so she winks back. And now you're feeling really firm, cause the girl is stacked. Reception's jumping, bass is pumping. Look at the girl and your heart starts thumping. Says she wanna dance to a different groove. Now you don't want to do G-Bust the move.
Let's do it. On the weekend comes, I go get live with the honey. Rolling down the street, I saw this girl when she was pumping. I winked my eyes, got into the ride, went to a club, was jumping. Introduced myself as Low, she said, you're a liar. I said, I got it going on, baby doll, and I'm on fire. Took her to the hotel, she said, you're the king. I said, be my queen, if you know what I mean, and let's do the wild thing. Wild thing. Shopping at the mall, looking for some gear to buy. I saw this girl, she gon' rock my world, and I had to adjust my fly. She looked at me and smiled and said, you have plans for the night? I said, hopefully if things go well, I'll be with you tonight. So we journeyed to a house, one thing led to another. I key in the door, I go hit the floor, looked up and it was a mother. I didn't know what to say, I was hanging by a string. She said, hey you too, I was once like you and I like to do the wild thing. Wild thing. She loved to do the wild thing. Wild thing. Please, baby, baby, please. Posse in effect. Hanging out is always hype. And with me and the crew, leave a shindig. I'm with a girl who's just my type. Saw this luscious little frame. I ain't lying, fella, she was fine. This sweet young Miss Cole gave me a kiss and I knew that she was mine. Took her to the limousine. Still parked outside. I tipped the chauffeur when it was over and I gave her my own ride. Didn't get her off my jock, she was I like static cling, but that's what happens when body starts slapping from doing a wild thing. Wild thing. She wanna do the wild thing. Discotheque, this fire chick was on my jock, so I said, what the heck? She wanted to come on stage and do a little dance, so I said, chill for now and maybe later, you'll get your chance. So when the show was finished, I took her around the way, and what do you know, she was good to go, without a word to say. We was all alone and she said, Tone, and let me tell you one thing, I need $50 to make you holler, I get paid to do the wild thing. Say what? Yo, love, you must be kidding. Yo, walk, you ready? Let's break out of here. Hasta la vista, baby.
It up while your feet are stumping and the jam is pumping. Look ahead, the crowd is jumping. Pump it up a little more, get the party going on the dance floor. See, cause that's where the party's at, and you find out if you do that. We'll be right back.
kicking up dust. So let me loosen up my cross strap and let me boost it with my raw rap. Cause I'ma break it down to the nitty gritty one time. When it comes to the lyrics, I get busy with mine. Busy as a beaver, you best believe her. This grand diva's running shit with the speed of a cheetah. Me the lyrical murderer, I'm serving them like two scoops of chocolate. Check out how I rock it. I'm the one that's throwing bolos. You better roll a rolo to find out I'm the number one solo. The capital R-A, now kick it to the G-E. I bring the things to light, but you still can't see me. I flow like the monthly, you can't cramp my style. For those that tried to poke me, here's a pampering child. No need to say mo, check the flow. Rage in the back, one smoke, so now you know I rock rough and stuff with my Afro punch. I rock rough and stuff with my Afro punch. Now I'm hitting them scenes like all you get. Ain't no doubt about it, I'm the undisputed. So what you wanna do is back on up. I'll tap that butt, wax the cut, pass the buck. So put your money on the breadwinner. I kick lyrics so dope that the brothers call them head spinners. I got the tongue that is outdone anyone. From the rising to the setting of the sun or the moon, I consume the room with doom. When I hear the kick of an 808 bass, boom, boom, bam, got. So hard you can say it's a grand slam dunk punk. Get broken off a chunk when they feel the funk of the rhythm that I give them. Let it hit them, split them, did it, now we're rid of them. Yeah, I put that on my unborn kids. Rage in the back, so you know how it is. I rock rough and stuff with my Afro punk.
Hey,
I rock rough and stuff with my Afro punk.
Hey,
I rock rough and stuff.
I rock
rough and stuff with my Afro punk. Now ever since my debut, I continue to lay you flat on your back from the raps that I spat. Spit, oh shit, I'm the shit. You can't get with the rage, then tough pity. I pity the fool that gets with the lyrical murderer, cause my shit is rude. You wanna get with the wickedness with that big bot hair that's kicking it, ripping it apart like Jason. You'll be chasing a dream like Freddy. Are you ready for the cream de la creme? I'm steam pressuring those who ain't measuring up. I keep competitors stuck in the muck with they butter. What you wanna nut up like cashew? Don't you know that I will mash you for real? That's the deal. I'm straight out of Farmville, VA.
So what you gotta say?
I rock rough and stuff with my Afro punk.
Rock on, what you
say? I rock rough and stuff with my Afro punk.
Rock on, what you say?
I rock rough and stuff with my Afro punk.
Hey, I rock on what you
say. I rock rough and stuff with my Afro punk.
Hey, rock on what you say.
I am the roughest, roughest, roughest.
Say what?
I am the toughest, toughest, toughest.
Hey,
I am the roughest, roughest, roughest.
Say what?
I am the toughest, toughest, toughest.
Hey,
I am the roughest, roughest, roughest.
Say what?
I am the toughest, toughest, toughest.
Hey,
I am the roughest, roughest, roughest.
Say what?
I am the toughest, toughest, toughest.
Hey,
get with the roughest, roughest. Get with the toughest, toughest.
Hey,
get with the roughest, roughest. Get with the toughest, toughest.
Hey,
get with the wickedness, roughest. I am the wickedness.
Gotta give credit where credit's due. Women back down and bow down to my motherfucking homegirl, the lady of rage. She rocks rough and stuff with the Afro puff. Handcuffed and she's fun. And trick bitch, she's guaranteed to tear shit up. You know what I'm saying?
Get it drunk, you came to get it on. More than 5 O's in your bank to get it on. Roll up like that thing can get it on. Plank to fit it on, came to get it on. Hold up, you wanna work that, twerk that. Let me in, let me hurt that, murk that. Say you gotta hurt back. Can't spit it out, boo, you gotta slurp that. Can't cut a rap that we doing, it wasn't worth that. Joey, I'm responsible for bringing dirt back.
back. She has the bar style and she's throwing it up. She drink a little Hypno, throwing it up. But I'm only dealing with freaks that wanna cut mine. If you agree and want nut, can't sort of get it played late night on BT Uncut. Do your thing, let me do my thing. I mean, do your thing, let me do my thing. Move that thing, mommy, move that thing.
Come on,
move that thing, mommy, move that thing.
Huh.
Do your thing, let me do my thing. Bump it out. I see some haters grilling. I see some ladies chilling. I see that girly I've been plotting again. You gotta hop in the whip and we come.
Bump it out.
Okay, we was leaving, we was done. She's second, my people's come. Here we go, I see it, don't stop. They wanna ride in something with a rim, don't stop. Look, baby, you fine, but your girlfriend's not. And as you wanna hold out, getting cute on the phone, I ain't gotta be bothered, be cute on your own. My jump off doesn't run off at the mouth so much. My jump off never asks why I go out so much. My jump off never has me going out of my way. And she don't want nothing on Valentine's Day. My jump off don't argue and get rebellious. And she don't mind hanging out with the fellas. My jump off's not insecure or jealous.
Do your thing, let me do my thing.
I mean,
do your thing, let me do my thing. Move that thing, mommy, move that thing.
Come on,
move that thing, mommy, move that thing.
Huh.
Do your thing, let me do my thing.
Y'all dudes keep talking about the ice and all the shine to it. That's a white goat cross with a real fine cupid. Might wanna fall in love like I'm Cupid. Telling me she don't get brain like I'm stupid. You can do anything if you put your mind to it. Get it?
Nope. Think about it.
The game is bad, play on. Ain't it bad, play on? Don't worry, Joey, you change it back, play on. Might have heard me spitting with Kane, it's bad, play on. I got it set towards it, bring it back, play on. Bang and slap, play on. Front man no longer playing a back, play on. Playing is that, play on. 808 bumping, bang the track. Player. Want my second win, change the back player. Jump off one man gang, I'm back player. Look, what you want, pump, double clip, pump, ride by, slump, jump off, homie, jump off. All these haters on my won't jump off. But all the streets need is jump off, jump off.
Do your thing, let me do my thing.
I mean,
do your thing, let me do my thing.
Thank y'all for hanging out with us. I hope y'all enjoying the mix. We got Sam on the wheels and steels.
Do your thing, let me do my thing.
Bump it out.
Do your thing, let me do my thing.
I mean,
do your thing, let me do my thing. Move that thing, mommy, move that thing.
Come on.
Move that thing, mommy, move that thing. Do your thing, let me do my thing.
Bump it out.
Dirty, making the mind. Look at her hips, what? Look at her legs, ain't she stacked? I sure wouldn't mind hitting that from the back. I like it when I touch her, cause she moan a little bit. Chain sagging, so I can see her thong a little bit. I know you grown a little bit, 20 years old, you legal. Don't trip off my people, just hop in the Regal. I swoop on her like an eagle, swoop down and pray. I know you popular, but you gon' be famous today, I'm saying. I like the way you do that right there,
right there.
Switch it up when you walk and let down your hair,
down your hair.
I like the way you do that right there,
right there.
Lick your lips when you're talking, that make me stir,
make me stir.
I like the way you do that right there,
right there.
Switch your lips when you're walking, let down your hair,
down your hair.
I like the way you do that right there,
right there.
Lick your lips when you're talking, that make me stir,
make me stir.
See me stopping at front and act, just look at her front and back. Man, she's so sad and she know that I want that. Her man, he's so whack. Girl, can I take your cat? Gave her 300 to strip, like buying a throwback. She stay in the club, like if we seen, she got it. I
honest. In real life, girl, remind me of Pocahontas. She be at advantage. Drop the press when she passed. Yeah. All the high roller cats wanna pay for that. Ain't no half stepping, stepping. Strapped with a nice weapon. It's a gift of law for her to move them hips. If you ever seen it dirty, your mouth gon' drop. Worldwide fools probably tell you this all hot. I like the way you do that right there. Right there. Switch your hips when you walk and let down your hair. Down your hair. I like the way you do that right there. Right there. Lick your lips when you're talking, that make me stir. Make me stir. I like the way you do that right there. Right there. Switch your hips when you walk and let down your hair. Down your hair. I like the way you do that right there. Right there. Lick your lips when you're talking, that make me stir. Make me stir. I like the way she doing that.
Come on.
Plus I like it when she bring it back. Hey. Ooh, 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 what you do?
Woo.
I like the way she doing that.
Come on.
Plus I like it when she bring it back.
Hey.
What you do?
Woo.
Give me what you got for a poke chop. She threw it at me like I was a showstop. Working in a fatty girl, hold the top. Then she backed it up for me and let it drop.
Drive.
Make it hot, point like a bunny.
Bunny.
Girl, can I bet you wear a sunny? Her appearance will make you give us some money. She's a post for Sports Illustrated. It's like a picture perfect sight. When she passed, all the other girls hate it. But I like the way you do that right there.
Right there.
Switch your hips when you walk and let down your hair.
Down your hair.
I like the way you do that right there.
Right there.
Lick your lips when you're talking, that make me stir.
Make me stir.
I like the way you do that right there.
Right there.
Switch your hips when you walk and let down your hair.
Down your hair.
I like the way you do that right there.
Right there.
Lick your lips when you're talking, that make me stir.
Make me stir.
I like that. I like that. I like that. I like that track star. Ooh, 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 what you do? I like that. I like that. I like that. I like that team. Ooh, 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 what you do?
All night, man, I be on it all day. Straight up pimp, if you want me, you can find me in the A. I'm on it, 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 I'm on it. Time and time again, I gotta turn back around and tell these hoes that I am the ace and I see bitch, that's just the way it goes. I be on that shit that I had you on that I don't want no more. At this time, I need all my freak hoes to get down on the floor. If you came to rep your set, write that nigga, let him know. If this jail, I get for stopping and hit it asleep, fuck it, I go. Freak, I be out in the week. Straight geeks working down your street in the stolen blind of bill with 23s on the feet. The legend Rocky Brown, back in time to be it down. Give me face, I love the sound. Slap the taste, they hit the ground. Back in the A, click the pick up with some P.I.s that don't play. On that kryptonite, we stay so high, we might fly away. I be on that kryptonite, straight up on that kryptonite. I be on that, straight up on that, I be on that kryptonite. I be on that kryptonite, straight up on that kryptonite. I be on that, straight up on that, I be on that kryptonite.
I be on it all night, man, I be on it all day. Straight up pimp, if you want me, you can find me in the A.
I'm on it, 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 I'm on it,
I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on it, I'm on
night, man, I be on it all day. Straight up pimp, if you want me, you can find me in the air. I'm on it, 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 time and time again, I gotta turn back round and tell C-Bone. Grab that cologne out my book bag, I smell draw all on you, home. Suppose the popos get a whip off the slip, if you get smoked, don't vote, won't trip. Papa will cause, call the K9 unit to the side of the road, let's take a smoke. Shit, the only thing we riding dirty is a UDKCB, Taco Berry, so may we be on our merry way, cause you just ain't gon' find no yay. Play, I got a tough team of attorneys, make a dozen like you sipping surfy. They play touch it, you can't touch me, verdict, be not guilty, search that.
Chevy Rob, slanging powder, Simpson roll through Dixie Hills. I'm pressed against that wood, candy paint, spinning wheels, grind time, rap gang member, bitches, killer, kill, purple ribbon, rolling O's, and we all be on that clear.
I'll be on that kryptonite, straight up on that kryptonite, I'll be on that, straight up on that, I'll be on that kryptonite, I'll be on that kryptonite, straight up on that kryptonite, I'll be on that, straight up on that, I'll be on that kryptonite.
I be on it all night, man, I be on it all day. Straight up pimp, if you want me, you can find me in the air.
I'm on it, 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 I'm on it,
I be on that kryptonite, straight up on that kryptonite, I be on that, straight up on that, I be on that kryptonite, I be on that kryptonite, straight up on that kryptonite. I be on that, straight up on that, I be on that kryptonite.
I be on it all night, man, I be on it all day. Straight up pimp, if you want me, you can find me in the air.
I'm on it, 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 I'm on it,
I'm on it, I'm on it.
What's up, y'all? Hit them hearts. I see y'all still holding us down tonight. Let's go.
What it is, ho? What's up? Can a nigga get in them good? Cut you up like you ain't been cool. Show your ass how to really catch a nigga. Well, give me your number and I'll call.
What's the business, baby? I've been on you all day in the mall, Miss Lady. You looking good. I think I seen your ass in the hood with your friends dressed up trying to front if you could. But anyway, go on and drop a number or something so I can call you later on your phone or something. Take you home and maybe we can bone or something. There's no limits to what we do, cause tonight we cutting gut busting. I'm digging in your walls, I'm vicious. With your legs to the ceiling, catching nuts, I'm serious. You delirious, or might I say you taste so delicious. With your pretty brown skin like almond joys and kisses. And you a certified head doctor, number one scholar that takes dick in the ass and won't holler. Bend you over and I'll follow you straight to the room where it goes down lovely in the Legion of Doom. What it is, ho, or what's up? Can a nigga get in them good? Cut you up like you ain't been cooked. Show your ass how to really catch a nigga. Well, give me your number and I'll call. And I'll follow that ass in the mall. Take you home, let you juggle my ball. While I'm being tanned down your ball.
Shit, you know the deal before a nigga ain't still. Damn it, that hot seems like it don't melt. You know I get it to you till you run out of breath. Then bust a nut all over yourself. The first time I call, you were jiggling on my balls. In and out of your jaws, I would beam down your walls. Had your ass breaking laws for a player was the cause. And every time you seen a G, you was slipping off your drawers. I recall, I met your ass at the mall. In the fall, you the one with the dress on. Let me take you home, show your ass how to bust a nut. Up in the guts, cut you up like you ain't been. Cut up from the back, then to the side. To the front, turn around. I smack them thighs any way that you want me. So go on, see about a pimp in that monk, yeah. And that's for sure.
What it is, ho, or what's up? Can a nigga get in them good?
get in them draws. I like the way your hands rub against my balls, cause you the one a nigga made us out to come out with your pretty brown skin, thick thighs and all. 135 for cheap, and your smell is unique. Maybe we can exchange numbers and hook up in a week. Oh, you a freak? I knew it from the first time I saw you. The way you play with your tongue, I knew right then I would call you. So what it is? They call me Super Dumb from the Ville, and I'ma tell you like this, cause a nigga so real and stay trill. Cause all I wanna do is just drill with that ass in the air and the pussy I kill. And I feel you love to fuck up on the hill, suck dick from behind and take nut in your grill. So bitch chill and shut your mouth just for a second. Why ladies dig down on you just like I'm telling? Hey,
it is, ho, what's up? Can a nigga get in them good? Cut you up like you ain't been.
So our mass joint is in the chat, y'all. Show some love.
Give me your number, and I'll call, and I'll follow that ass in the mall. Take you home, let you juggle my ball, while I'm beating 10 down.
I hope y'all enjoyed the music while Sam took over. I'll be the captain on the rest of this ride. We got about a good 20 minutes to go before we land. This was Sam's last song before she vacated the seat, so I gotta play it for y'all. Show over, y'all. She got them jams.
It's on. Prince of Punk, bitch.
Yeah, boss,
motherfucking head split.
got over 1,725 people rocking with us, y'all. 38 countries. We growing. Let's go.
Huey.
I remember this one.
Huey.
Stop throwing papers!
Hey, this right here. This right here. Sound like that new bounce. By the way, H-U-E-Y. Boy, hits limited. Yep. Pot. Po-po, you a fool for this one.
Toot that thing up, mommy, make it roll. Once you pop, pop, lock it for me, girl, get low. If your mama gave it to your baby girl, let it show. Once you pop, pop, drop it for me, maybe we can roll. Oh!
Pop, lock, and drop it.
There you go, Tick. Pop, lock, and drop it.
Tonight is gonna be some changes. No access to dig it, so stop acting and get it clapping. Cause I'm knowing you feel me. Yeah, you cute, but don't let this go to your head. Cause what this cutie won't do, pimping another one will. You prefer rocking the skirt, and your heels so tall. And we ain't with none of that tricking, but I feel so tall. I've been peeping you for a while, and you throwing it back. If you looking for you, a follow. We got dough in the back. Look, your color Carmelo Brown, and your skin so smooth. I'm having fantasies about what you and me can do. And you a undercover freak, you probably thinking the same. I'm saying light up on your face, press your feet with my chain. And I ain't trying to put you out there as if you were free. So don't even take it that way, just say you did it for me. And you will probably roll with me, cause there's money in my pocket. So before then, I gotta see you pop, lock, and drop it. Toot that thing up, mommy, make it roll. Once you pop, pop, lock it for me, girl, get low. If your mama gave it to your baby girl, let it show. Once you pop, pop, drop it for me, maybe we can roll. Oh!
Pop, lock, and drop it.
Hey, I'm telling y'all right now, it's gonna be all about you, dog. When this Notebook Paper album drop, watch what I tell you, we gonna get paper.
I ain't gotta be your man, but I really wouldn't mind. We ain't gotta talk again, I'm just trying to have a time. If you a baller, pull a sack out and slap her on the A. Pop, lock it, cop, blockers, get up out the way. Let the mommy get low, give us space, let us sweat. The club turning to hooters, cause they shirts are so wet. From the windows to the wall, the mama showing the song. The block freaking herself, you're telling me that it's gone. You ready, then we can roll. I'm telling you, we can go. I'm thinking if I can handle it the way you make it roll. We grooving and speeding up, you're right in between us. If you a strip, feed up, then baby don't seize up. At first I thought I was tripping, but my vision getting clearer. You moving that thing around as if you practice in the mirror. She doing the new dance, what the next man said. I'm like, nah, she just pop locking on a headstand. Toot that thing up, mommy, make it roll. Once you pop, pop, lock it for me, girl, get low. If your mama gave it to your baby girl, let it show. Once you pop, pop, drop it for me, maybe we can roll. Oh!
Pop, lock, and drop it.
Y'all know what's going on. You're listening to your boy Cali Pitts and my co-host Sam Pitts on a Good Conversation Show, KGCN Radio. And y'all know what we doing. Before we let y'all go, we gonna hit y'all with nothing but some good hits and a good mix. Y'all remember this?
Rock.
like how she rock it. She bend that thing over into the ground, she gon' drop it. And pop it hard as she can. Got me hard in the pants because she all in her stance, doing her.
The mayor's in the building. You know I voted for you.
She rock her hips to the bass. She take a sip and she wait. And wanna get with Lil J after she dance on that pole. I pull my castle quick and fast when that to the floor.
Now I got 32 flavors of that bootylicious bubblegum. Raspberry, grape, cherry, come and get this honey bun. Yummy, yum, baby, not your ordinary lady. Known to drive a crazy Willy Wonka wanna pay. On the daily, off the heels, I rock my heels, I shake my skittles. Soda poppy, watch it sizzle, man, it right here for shizzle. Smoking on the highest drizzle, wanna taste it just a little. Rock my hips and make it wiggle, waving, sipping in the
I like
wiggle.
It when she rock her hips, then wave and sip. She rock her hips, then wave and sip. She rock her hips, she rock her hips, she rock her hips, then wave.
I like it when
she rock her hips, then wave and sip. She rock her hips, then wave and sip. She rock her hips, she rock her hips, she rock her hips. Then wait,
I like it when she show me she can rock and roll and drop it to the floor. That's a slow, shout it's all pro, that's the way to go. Tell her booty, ooh, we got a glancing every time that react. I thought a pretty cat, give me that fat cat. Don't act on a pimp, you got me enticed. By the way, you run them hips, you can trill. Girl, doing all them tricks, that's what's up. I like that a lot, come and holler at
us. Hey, I'm the top notch glamour chick. Tell me if I throw it at you, baby, can you handle it? Quick to cause it's rushing. If I hate a one to run they lip, step up in the club and have them whispering, got she said. Take it to the bar, hypnotic and Hennessy is on my lips. Seductively moving my body, now watch me rock my hips. Take a sip of the goose, I'm looking good and living lavish. Big boy pimping, popping, dipping, now tell me I'm not the
I baddest. Like it when she rock her hips, then take it low. She grabs the towel and wipes.
One more for y'all before we get up out of here. I want to let y'all know we here Monday through Sunday, 8 a.m. in the morning, 12 p.m. in the afternoon, and also 7 p.m. at night. We appreciate y'all for hanging out with us. This is the last song off of Sam's playlist. We hope y'all have a blessed night. Y'all know, like I always say, y'all stay safe. We're going to do the same. Peace.
Welcome to the world of Young Jock, a 14,000 square foot monster, 8 bedrooms, 5.5 baths, a pool, jacuzzi, a lake, and a helicopter pad, on 93 acres in Atlanta. Let's see how Jock lives.
Hey, yo, what up, y'all? This your homie Young Jock, man. Welcome to Bad Boy Cribs and Block Entertainment. It's going down right here, and you get a first-hand look. Let's go.
Any, many, mighty, mo, how many girls from the club wanna go?
I know you see it, I know you see it.
I'm like any, many, mighty, mo, how many players in the club wanna go?
I know you see it, I know.
Now you can call me Tip Drill, playing my songs. Throw a couple ones, then she throw away her thongs. When she bust it open, take a picture with my phone. She love my cologne, Unforgivable by Sean. And now she jocking, it's going down. Slap the waitress on the booty, tell her get another round. And when I make it rain, money all over the ground. Fresh Force One, Sean John, button down. And then I'm like, oh boy, my clique full of stars. Big 4-2, big, you can big car. At the end, end of the day, when it's all said and done, I'ma need for
got jockers with Puffy.
How many girls from the club wanna go?
I know you see it. I know you see it.
You like Bill, Bam, I know you want some. She chewing on that shit like a piece of bubble yum.
I know you see it. I know you see it.
I'm like any, how many players in the club won't go?
I know.
Damn, damn,
I know you want some. You're chewing on a foot like a piece of bubble yum.
I know you see.
Everybody
hit them hearts before y'all go. No doubt.
My cup on full, fitted on lean. Jeans sag low, but my wrist ain't mean. It's your birthday set, girl. What you gon' do? Pop a couple bottles just to pour it on you. If you with it, I'm with it. Gon' let me know. Throw the money in the air, watch it fall like snow. I know how to work a pole. Climb to the top, bring it down real slow. Oh, damn, look who just called. My homie Big Block say we finna buy it all. Chris, the Goose, go Patron, Lime Juice. When the DJ play this record, everybody get loose. Go dumb, go dumb. Shout it, what's up, where you from? Where you from? Shout it, throw it up. I know you see it. I know you see it. I'm like Bill and Bam, I know you want some. She chewing on that juice like a piece of bubble yum.
I know you see it. I know you see it.
I'm like any, mind, how many players in the club won't go?
When I drop the work in the potty, bounce back like elastic. How you do that? I call it dope boy magic. Watch me work them plays like that 95 Madden. How you do that? I call it dope boy magic.
I get a 9 in the morning, by the 90 jet back. How you do that? I call it dope boy magic. I'm fresh and deaf every day, like I jumped up out of casket. How you do that? I call it dope boy magic.
Even on the one to turn a pair of Bo Jackson Raiders into a fresh Maury Alligators. 3 out of 10 news and some haters before it's too late. 5 shots to your tater. 600 chrome fronted cotton candy coated beans. 7 groups of presidential blowing in the winter. 4 in the 8th at 9 touchdown. A beautiful play in my neighborhood. So what now? Got 1 left. You can snatch it for the 7. Keep your chirp on alert just like 9-11. Now 12 creeping through the hood like Jason. Keep it moving. Friday 13, but this ain't a movie. I was only 14 when I got my first deal. Made a two-way disappear like David Copperfield. While I recorded this at 2:15. Now, boy, magic beating through your 15. When I drop the work in the potty, bounce back like elastic. How you do that? I call it dope.
Thank y'all for hanging out with us again. It's time for us to go.